I guess my far from home journey begins here. I'm going to America to study abroad for a whole year, and also it'll be my first time ever traveling alone without my family, so it'll be a pleasure to have y'all stay and keep me company. Guess who's going to bed at 5 p.m.? I have my flight tomorrow at 7 a.m., but I have to meet the rest of the people at the airport by 3 a.m., so. I woke up and we went straight to the airport. We needed to go to Japan to connect our flight, so after saying goodbye to my family, I made a few friends who are also going on this exchange program, and that's why it pulled away all the stars I had. I'm thrilled to have an orientation in the US and meet new people, so I really hope everything is on time and the flight won't be delayed at all. The flight wasn't delayed. It got canceled. So thank you for making us waste our time on board without any notice for nothing. It went from a 30-minute delay to a 4-hour delay to an announcement that the flight has officially been canceled due to aircraft management. But viewing this optimistically, though it was an unfortunate experience, it's still one I'll forever remember, and it's a great story to tell. Wait, what just happened? I took a shower. How is that possible? Okay, here's a little update. So, since the flight got canceled, right, the airline decided to take responsibility for us, which is providing us this 5-star hotel room and a mediocre lunch, which was pretty cool. But I don't really know what's the next step to this, because we're still in Bangkok. We're not in Tokyo, we're not in Newark. We're still at home, basically, so. I'm waiting for the update from OEG and we'll see what we have to do next, I guess. I'll update y'all later. See y'all soon.
But we didn't actually stay overnight at the hotel because we rebooked our next flight at 1 a.m. on the dot. We're going to Korea instead. I guess it wasn't too bad at all. It was a pretty exhausting day, so I slept all the way there. And I missed a meal on board. It wasn't really a big deal, but my friend said it was really delicious too, so. Whatever. My butt hurts so much from the 6 hours of purely sitting on the plane, but we've got our next 13 hours to go, and now we're going from Korea to America. So I slept for another 5 hours. It's like I had hours of full sleep, but not that full, cause I'm second guessing whether I should have a kid or not. Anyways, I got to eat this time, twice, plus an appetizer. It was so good though, I wanted to raise my hand for a second one, but was too shy to. Dang, I should have been brave to make use of the money I paid, but like, never mind, I guess. I can finally say that we have now arrived at JFK Airport. I made it to the other side of the world. To New York City. I see why everybody is so obsessed with this place. And you know what? I think I am too.
Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today.
The hotel's giving a weird vibe. I mean, hear me out. What the heck? all in all, I think the overall design of the hotel was pretty majestic. Even the fog made it look twilight-ish, if you ask me. So if it wasn't because I was scared of the hallways, I'd want to be here, actually. The night was over so quickly, I didn't even sleep for very long and needed to wake up super early because I am expected to meet my host family today for the first time ever. I guess I need to be on my own for the rest of the journey now. I'll make lots of friends, be at a place I hope to be at, and live the life I've wanted my entire life. I hope so. Nothing pleases me more than you. My journey begins here. So wish me good luck. Cause I do wish myself good luck too.